John Richardson, Sean Locke, Joe Wilkinson, Harriet Hemsley, James Beach, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy Cobb.
Hello and welcome to AR10 Cats Just Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. It's the show where we learn our ABCs and mind our P's and Q's with a right bunch of C-U-N... Well, you get the idea. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson! John Richardson is a 36-year-old stand-up comedian from Lancaster, but he self-identifies as an 86-year-old pensioner whose friends are dead. And joining John tonight is Harriet Hemsley. Harriet is a young, fresh-faced female comedian who's excited to be on the show. She's basically the exact opposite of Sean Locke. Fun fact, Harriet is allergic to nuts, so she's also the opposite of Susie Dent, who can't get enough of them. Up against them this evening, it's Sean Locke. Indeed. Sean and Susie both grew up in Surrey. They weren't at school together, though Sean was in the same class as Susie's granddad. And Sean's teammate, Joe Wilkinson. With his glossy beard, playful nature and ability to follow simple commands, Joe would make an excellent pet. Although he does shit wherever he wants, so you'd have to tie him up outside. Harry, you've been married for 1 year now.
Yes, 1 year, 6 months, 2 days.
It's like a prison sentence.
Yeah, nearly out, yeah.
What would you consider a success, like, in terms of marriage? How long would you stay married?
Well, I think the thing is, because I was single for such a long time before I met him, like, because I always thought, like, to be in a relationship, you have to be perfect. Like, that's what I think, you have to be perfect. So I thought, what happens is you meet someone and then you just pretend that you're perfect, you know? You just, like, hide that crazy deep down, you know? And then, like, you go out for a bit and you're like, keep pretending that you're normal. Then you go a bit longer, you're like, I'm falling for this. Yeah, just keep it up. I thought, what happens is one day you get married and you're like, surprise!
Genuinely frightening. John, if you could swap bodies with anyone for a day, who would it be?
Oh.
Probably a man, wouldn't it?
I would probably take Joe Wilkinson's body for a day. You know, like when you have a really shit day out and it rains and you miss the train and then you get home and you think, God, my house is amazing. I imagine that's what it would be like the day after I was in Joe Wilkinson's.
Is that a compliment?
Yes.
You're welcome.
Okay, Harry, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I do. Because last time I was here, I wasn't very logical. And so I found this diary that I wrote when I was younger, and in it I wrote this pros and cons list. So I bought it to remind me to be logical. And this pros and cons list I wrote when I was a teenager about whether I should date this boy. See if you think I should have dated him, right? Okay. In the pros list I've written, he's funny. That's good, isn't it? Yeah, and then I've written, he'd treat me well. But then I've crossed that out and I've written, he'd worship me. And then I've written, he lives in Canterbury, that's where I lived, handy. And then in the cons list, I've written, he's annoying, he lies, and this is my favourite one, he has a cold house. Sorry, mate, not interested, too cold. Do you think I should have gone out with him? No, well, we've been married a year now, so...
Joe, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I've brought along my car.
Well, sorry, as a mascot?
Yeah, brought my car along as a mascot. reason being... reason I bought it, Jimmy, is it... because it brings me good luck. No other reason.
Can't help but notice there's a for sale sign in the window.
Shut the fuck up. But out of interest, it's a lovely little run around. Only 175 miles on the clock. AM, FM radio.
Is this your mascot, or are you trying to sell your car?
Yeah, I'm trying to sell my car, yeah. Yeah, I'll be honest with you, I've forgotten he was in there. just a friend of mine who likes to sleep in my boot, my car with no clothes on. So if you buy the car, he does come with the car.
Get on the phone.
WeBuyAnyCar.com.
No, they don't, weirdly.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Oh, yeah, I do, yeah.
Well, Jimmy, my mascot is... I'm sure you're well aware of the fact that one of the easiest ways to make money in this business that we call show business is to entertain children. It's the easiest way to make a few quid. They'll buy, watch, listen to any old shit you come up with. And the least discerning consumers ever, because they don't pay for it. Now, that's a saturated market. Everybody's onto that one. But there's another market, right, which is not quite as lucrative, but it's still uncharted territory for many of us. A few smart fellas have got in there early. Bradley Walsh, our very own Jason Manford, Alexander Armstrong. And of course, I'm talking of the Nana market. The grey pound, as they call it, or as I like to call it, the Dusty Pound. Now, they love nothing better than a good old-fashioned sing-song. A lovely album, a nice young man singing a lovely old song they remember well. And I'm talking about, you know, your proper nanas. You know, I'm not talking about your modern northern nana. You know, who's 41, does weightlifting. So I thought, let's get in on this market. And I've created this album. It's called Nan, That's What I Call Music.
What kind of songs do you have on
there? Well, we've got all songs there. We've got Let's Share a Toffee Together. Yes. Rita of the Pit Canteen. What a lovely song. Let's get our teeth done together. Just old, lovely old songs we all know.
Could you maybe give us a bit of a belt on one of these? Could you give us a little... No, well, we would love to hear a song, wouldn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think people would really love to hear...
Well, if you insist, Jimmy. If you insist.
I've got three for everyone. He's even got a walk. Look at that walk. I'm buying the album. I don't even need to hear it. I'm buying it. Just walk alone.
I'd like to start with, I think, a song we all know and love very well. It's, of course, called Let's Share a Toffee Together. I don't have a band, so I'd have to imagine the enormous melody that will be supporting my voice. But remember this one. Everybody, come and sing along if you know it. Let's share a toffee together, Maud. You know it's been a long time since I shared a sweet treat with you. My kit bag's in the parlour. Tell me, how's your father? There's no laughing on the album, actually. I'll undo the wrapper. We won't need no supper. And when it gets a little sticky, I won't get tricky, because I'm around forever. More.
Oh, another. You've got to do another.
I think
there's
one more, isn't it?
Right, this one.
Well,
you all know this one. Of course, yes. It's of course it's Rita from the Pit Canteen. I think that's
it's a classic.
And if I've got time, you've got liberty, I'd like to do that for you. Please, please don't laugh because it's a very moving song. Here we go. He stammered and he stumbled as he tasted the crumble from Rita of the Pit Canteen. Hey, everybody. Oh, how he did linger over his third fish finger from Rita of the Pit Canteen. His heart's all aflutter for a slice of bread and butter from Rita of the Pit Canteen. Thank you, everybody. He'd swim... He'd swim the seven seas for a taste of a mushy pea. Rita from the Pit Canteen. A romance started budding with a double helping of pudding. Rita from the Pit Canteen. But it all went chilly when he found the willy of Peter in the Pit Canteen. She had gravy on her badge. And no sign of veg. Peter from the Pit Canteen. As his workmates laughed, he threw himself down the shaft. And we can hold this, we can cut backwards and forwards. Oh, 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 Rita. Not a big ending, that one.
Big money, big, big money. You won't see me for dust. Once this comes out, there'll be some other clown sitting here. Because I'll be... massive boat. Thanks, Nanners.
John, have you got a mascot?
Well, it's good news, Jimmy. I'm pleased to report that my series of erotic novels, Deep Clean, has finally become a Hollywood blockbuster film. Here's the sneak preview of the poster for the movie. It's Deep Clean the movie, 9.5 streaks. It's about a cleaner who, just a regular cleaner, goes around to someone's house. It's a filthy house, gets held hostage and sort of paraded around to look at all the dirt. So the strapline for the movie, germs can hold you prisoner, Sif can set you free. And I'm very excited, as a sneak preview, as a treat for the audience, we're going to have a little scene I've been authorised. So I'll be doing the Ryan Gosling role. Harry, if you don't mind playing, you're the role of the lady taking hostage the cleaner. That's Nicole Kidman in the film. There's also a role for Danny DeVito, which I thought, Joe, if you don't mind... I know you can act.
I've seen
you in court. Your character, if you don't mind, I'm sure you've worn one of these before.
Oh, I know those ones.
Pop that straight on in there.
Do you need help
tying it round the back,
are
you?
Good little model, this one. Sturdy, yeah.
Yeah, I got it second hand.
Can he breathe?
Can he breathe?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got a nose, Harry.
So to set the scene, this is in the kitchen. I, Ryan Gosling, are naked on all fours. You might pick up on some of the lines will remind you of other films you've seen. That is entirely coincidental and is in no way an infringement of copyright.
Sure. Can you hurry up?
Yeah, sure. Sorry, Joe. Harry, take it away.
This is really hot, isn't it?
Yes, it is hot. I'm glad you rubbered up first. That ring has taken some serious damage.
I'm going to pull it out now. Are you ready?
Yes, I am ready. My God. Have you ever cleaned behind this oven?
Not since I moved in 6 years ago.
Jesus, I just want to spray everywhere. I feel faint. Could I have something to eat?
Yes. There's a raw chicken breast in the fridge.
I don't eat meat.
Wow. What a selfless and responsible decision to take to benefit the planet.
quite so. This chicken, is it in a... This chicken... Is it in a sealed container at the bottom of the fridge?
No, it's in a dirty wine glass at the top of the fridge, next to the lettuce.
You crazy bastard. You'll never get away with this. Hang on, I can't see any lettuce.
It's right in front of you.
Where?
Iceberg, dead ahead. If you don't want chicken, I can make you a toastie.
Can I at least call my wife to tell her I'm okay?
Later, after you're toastie.
I'd rather do it now.
No, eat tea, phone home.
That was great. Did Joe have any lines at all?
Yeah, now I realise it. Your character doesn't actually have any lines in that scene.
Who can't will?
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's James Veitch. James Veitch is here. And I know what you're thinking, ladies. Maybe he could fix my laptop. James, what have you been up to recently?
I've been doing a lot of corporate gigs. A lot of companies have been hiring me. And I go there, every time I kind of do one of these companies, I kind of lose a bit of my soul, but I gain a bit of a house. So that's nice. Whenever I do it, they give me kind of a sort of a contract to sign, right? And it's always the same. It's kind of, it says James Veitch, and it has title, right? And I don't have a title, but the other person had written president. So I was like, well, fuck it. And I just wrote vice CEO, of the chairman, board of chair. I don't think anyone checks these. Do you know what I mean? And then this person wrote event manager. I just said 100% professional businessman. And then this is my version of James Veitch saying audio importanza. I don't know what that means.
I like it. James Veitch, everyone. We'll have more from you later on. And with James, of course, is Susie Dent. Susie's here. Susie once gave a talk called American English, How Have We Gotten Here? The lecture looked at national rivalries and asked, is it time to embrace the new American vocabulary? Tell me, Susie, was it as boring as it sounds?
Yes.
Susie, you've been on tour recently, taking audience questions. What's the strangest thing you've been asked?
There was a lot about you. You were the number one theme.
What was the most common question about me?
Were you real?
OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel, you studied quantum theory at university. Does it ever come in handy?
There's loads of really crazy things to do with quantum. But the good thing about it is no one really understands it, so you can say what you like and use it however you want. But the thing that most people know is it only applies on the teeny tiny level. So for John... I'm glad you asked, Jimmy. No one ever asked me about quantum, especially at parties.
We're not at a party. OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the countdown recorder. Take it away, Fabio. Sean and Joe, you get the pick of the letters.
OK, so up to now, consonant, please. Let's get on with this. A vowel, please.
E.
Oh, smash it.
Consonant, please.
S.
Vowel, please.
A.
I'm out.
That's spelled with a Z. a vowel, consonant, please.
T.
Vowel, please.
I.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
Oh, God.
Z.
I would like a...
Another Z.
Consonant, please.
N.
Oh, turn it on his side.
and your time starts now.
I think I got him. John, how many letters?
Seven.
Harry, how many letters?
Five.
Hey, five's okay.
Thank you. I ate brain food. I didn't, because I'm vegetarian, so I was like, I heard that if you ate fish, it would make you smarter, but I'm vegetarian, so I just ate chips. I think it had the right effect.
Sean, how many?
Seven.
Seven. Joe?
Risky. Seven.
Okay, Harry, what's your five?
Tides.
John, your seven?
Salient.
Salient, hell of a word.
It's got to be a real word, though, isn't it?
what was your risky seven, Joe?
Slanted.
Slanted?
I say it's slanted.
That's called the whole
perfect.
Thing off.
Yeah, perfect. We're in.
Yeah, you're
oh,
in.
Is it real?
Of course it is. Yeah.
Okay.
Very good.
Sean, what was yours?
Stained.
OK, 7 points for both teams. A fine start. James, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, they could have done. I mean, I'll be honest, we came up with an eight. When I say we, I had nothing to do with this. I was just sitting here, I just did this, and then she came up with de-install, so...
De-install. OK, so at the end of that, both teams have 7 points. Mm. OK, on to our first numbers round. John, Harry, your first pick of the numbers.
Great.
Please.
Two big ones, please. Two small ones. Then what do you think?
Two more small ones.
Thank you. Yes.
Anytime. The four little ones are 1, 6, 2 and 10, and the big ones 25 and 100.
Love the 100.
Good for you, Joe. The
target. OK, you're going to be like that.
OK, well, the target is 863. Your time starts now. OK, 863 was the target. Joe, did you get it?
No, I didn't, Jimmy. It was almost impossible.
Sean, did you get it?
Hmm?
OK.
No.
No, OK. John, did you get it?
I got 863.
Harry, did you get it?
I think I got 862, which is... Mm. I mean, it's not the answer, but... It's still not the answer. It's one off.
OK. Well, John, how did you get 863? Let's see if you got it right.
10 minus 1 is 9.
10 minus 1 is 9.
Times 100.
900.
Minus 25.
875.
And minus 2 times 6.
Perfect. Well done.
10 points to John! And here is your teaser. The words are fart glue, and the clue is, thank you very much. That's fart glue. Thank you very much. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were fart glue. The clue was, thank you very much. It was, of course, grateful. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Harriet.
I can't relax, because I feel like Sean's going to strip off his waistcoat any moment, because it's Velcro.
Well, that's why I wore this, because it's a three-piece suit, because I like a three-piece suit. I was going to wear a four-piece suit, which is actually with a cape.
I thought you'd come dressed as me.
Yeah, it's quite easy, isn't it? Find some boring clothes and put them on.
OK, so, Harriet, your turn to choose.
Please, could I have a consonant and a vowel E. And, a consonant, L. And a vowel, please. A consonant, please.
N.
And another consonant.
Yep.
A vowel, please. And E. Could I get a consonant, please? Shall I get a consonant?
Yeah, why not?
A consonant, please.
Why not?
L. Okay.
Okay, and your time starts now.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I can't
remember what's happening. I'm trying to get my ring off. I'm trying to get that ring. Grab it. Yeah, grab that. Yeah, pull it. Pull it. Yeah, pull as hard as you can. Pull it harder. Yeah, that should be it. Ooh. Ah, no. Ooh. Is that not coming off? Yank it.
Sorry.
Put my shoulder out.
Your ring fell off.
At least there are problems now. How many did you get?
I think I got 6.
You should see my dick, by the way.
I don't think I want to. Thank you. Thank you, though.
Sean?
I got 6.
OK, Harry, what was your 6?
Loners.
Loners? And what about being with John gave you the idea for loners?
I don't know, it just came to me.
Yeah, I got loners and nosher.
OK, could they have done any better, James, Susie?
Yes. Hollers for 7.
Hollers.
Hollers, you know, someone hollers at you.
6 points to both James. OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Joe have 13, John and Harry have 23. Right, now time for John and Joe to go head-to-head. Joe, your turn to pick the numbers.
4 big ones.
You want 4 big ones?
Oh, yeah. Just want to make sure neither of us get it.
It's a very good idea at this stage.
I need this to be 150 now.
Right. 666.
I knew I had a hand in this.
Okay, that's way too hard.
Okay, your time starts now. Okay, so the target was 666. Joe, did you get it?
663.
Oh, pretty good, pretty close. John, did you get it?
I think I got 667.
How did you get 667?
100 plus 25.
100 plus 25.
Times 25. By 5.
Times 5 is 625.
Add 50.
675.
And minus 8.
Yep, yeah, gets you to 1 away, 667.
Don't clap him.
7 points for John.
Good.
Rachel, could it be done?
I've got 2 one away as well, so leave it with me.
What's wrong?
I'm still working on it.
But it's your full-time job.
I know.
We're going to come back to you
in
a bit,
okay.
But I just want everyone to know that you've let us down. OK, so Sean and Joe have 13, John and Harry have 30. OK, time now to go over to Dictionary Corner. James Veitch, what have you got for us?
Well, I got an email that was not meant for me. I know that it was meant for Alan and Deb Veitch. I have no idea who these people are, OK? But it was from a company. Basically, a guy called Lex runs a company called Relax Pools. And the pool was 102LF, right? And I didn't know what that stood for, but I just thought, you know, screw it, let's reply. So I replied, and I said, what does LF stand for? And they got back to me. They said LF stands for linear feet. Janice did not seem to mind or notice the fact that I was neither Alan nor Deb, and I thought, that is interesting. She said, see attached plans. Alan and Deb's house, top left, the proposed pool. And I want to be very clear, guys, you should never reply to an email that's not meant for you. You shouldn't do it. However, I just didn't think Alan and Deb were going to be happy with that. I said, Janice, I'm going to be frank. I'm unhappy with the size of the pool. She said, Mr. Veach, it's not legal to build on private property. The pool is as large as it can be without encroaching on your neighbour's property. I said, old man McPherson? He won't mind. We're still skimping on the size of the pool. I don't want people to come round and be like, where's the pool? Ball's on the line, Janice. It needs to be larger. How much larger? I said, boom. That is not possible. No shit, Janice. We cannot build that close to the property. Well, I took out the issue and I said that. I'll be honest, I thought that she would know that I was joking. But no, she said, where will you live? I said, boom.
James Veach, everyone.
Did you want the answer?
To the question from way earlier.
Yeah.
I'm sort of a little bit of a stickler for I like to get it within 30 seconds.
I've heard, yeah, we all know Caroline.
Could it be done?
It could, yes. If you say 75, the pen's even died because I've been there so long. By five is 375. Plus 8 is 383. 50 over 25 is 2. Times them together for 766 and take away the 100 for 66.
OK, the scores at the moment, Sean and Joe have 13, John and Harriet have 30. And here's your teaser. The words are groin tan. The clue is that was bliss. That's groin tan. That was bliss. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were groin tan. The clue was that was bliss. It was, of course, ignorant. OK, on with the game. Sean and Joe, your turn to choose the letters.
OK, let's have a consonant, please.
Hey, Sean.
I'm going to stop saying please as well, Rachel. I'll just say a please at the end.
OK.
Or a thank you at the end. Vowel.
Please.
You.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
God love you.
Oh.
Consonant.
Ta.
Why?
Vowel.
Up yours.
A.
Consonant.
G.
This is toss.
Consonant.
This is absolute toss.
N.
Vowel.
And I.
OK, and your time starts now. Did you get?
I got lots of ones, but they're not words. Five.
John, how many?
Five.
Joe, how many?
Five.
John?
Six.
Ooh, that's good.
Okay, Harriet, what was your five?
Futon.
Futon. Okay, John, what was your five?
Unity.
Okay, Joe, your five?
Gonna blow your mind here. Futon.
And you're six, Sean.
It's something that you'll find me doing to you, Jimmy, quite a lot. Toying. And I toy with you. I play with you. I use you as my toy.
6 points to Sean.
Yes.
Brilliant. Done. All right. James, Susie, could they have done any better?
What have we got?
Just sixes. Yeah. Toying, notify, new girl. Acting, six was tops.
OK, so at the end of that, John and Harry are in the lead with 30 points. OK, on to another numbers round. OK, John, Harry, you're to pick the numbers. Try and pick easy ones, because I'd love it if Rachel got this one in the time.
One big one and five little ones.
Classic.
Oh, standard. My God, this is going to be classic John.
Classic John.
Oh, nine. He's got his cardigan on, it's some classic John.
Classic John, 69.
69.
Don't listen to the filth, Rachel. Don't listen to the filth. Protect yourself.
100. 50. Six. And the target, 344.
OK, and your time starts now. Try and get it this time, Rachel. Try and get it within the time. Well, Joe's using his fingers. This does not bode well. Target was 344. Harriet, did you get it?
I'm gonna take a Donald Trump approach and be wrong confidently. Is that it?
That is the Donald Trump approach. Just say that.
Isn't anything.
Yeah.
As far as I'm concerned, 344 is not even a number. I admit a lot of numbers. They're good guys. I like numbers, but that's not a number. I know that. I can do the little noise that Yoda makes. Yeah. Mm. I can do Popeye's laugh.
And Donald Trump.
And Donald Trump, and that's my show.
I'm quite a specialist.
I can do a clown's car horn.
Go on. OK. John, did you get it?
Yes.
OK. Sean, did you get it?
Yes.
Joe, I'm guessing by your exclamation as the clock finished that you got this one. Did you get it?
290.
OK, Sean, how did you do it?
9 minus 8...
1.
..is 1. But you add that 1 to a 6.
7! Ah!
And then you do that times 50.
350.
And then you take off the other 6.
Marvellous.
Oh, you little dancer. John, how did you do it?
The same way.
Well, 10 points for both teams. Time now for another little trip over to Dictionary Corner. James Veitch, what have you got for us?
I got a text message that was not meant for me, and I know that because it began, "Hi, Phil." I'm not Phil. But it said, "My name's Andrew. I'm one of the new tenants at 11 Dover Place, and I've been told you're the person to contact regarding upkeep, problems, etc." And I said, I'm not actually. And I was just composing another message explaining the fact that he probably got the number wrong by a digit or so. But before I had a chance to send that, he said, "Actually, you are." He said, "According to the leasing agreement, you're responsible for looking after 11 Dover Place from a maintenance perspective." There was only one thing I could do. My hands were tied. I said, "My mistake. How can I help? Phil." And we were off. He said, "I'm in the bedroom with ensuite. Can a thermostatic valve be fitted at the tower rail in the bathroom as it's making the room unbearably hot?" And I sort of got myself into Phil's shoes and I thought about it and I was like, no can do. But I'm having my builder come around on Wednesday to remove one of the windows. This should stop the bedroom overheating. He said, "Hi, Phil, I'm at work on Wednesday. Can you clarify what you meant when you said you were removing a window?" I said, "Don't worry, I'm not removing a window. That would be ridiculous. I'm getting a professional to do it." "We should achieve a nice summer breeze to combat the tower rail heat." And he said, "Can you please explain what you mean by removing windows?" Now, at this point, I think if you were Andrew, you'd probably be wondering, quite correctly as it happened, whether I was indeed Phil. But I want him to think that, because by this point, I had plans. So what I went, Google's amazing, right? Because I just Googled the address, and the first thing that came up was like an archive page for the realty thing for 11 Dover Place, and that included a floor plan. And I thought, shit, that is very useful. Because that enabled me to do this. I made a little animation. I said, "Look, this is the plan for Wednesday. Now watch carefully, guys. Here we go." I'm made that into like an animated GIF, and I sent it to him via iMessage. But what I didn't realise at the time was animated GIFs, when you send them via iMessage, they just repeat. So it was basically just. I said, look, FYI, to take full advantage, you'll need to keep your bathroom door open at all times. He said, this is unacceptable. If you do this on Wednesday, my lawyer will be in touch. And I said, look, Andrew, from Wednesday, expect the flat to be out of action for 6 weeks as we initiate the following four-step plan. Guys, I was having a really good time. I mean, I said, look, first step one, remove all four walls. Step two, expand bathroom. Step three, isolate towel rail within refrigeration dome. Step four, counteract remaining towel rail heat with tower of ice. I've just spoken to the real landlord, so you can knock it off. No problem. Out of interest, did he agree to sort the towel rail? He said, stop looking at me! I said, go on, did he? Yes.
Yay!
So happy ending.
James Beach, everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are sad reach. The clue is, hope you're good with your hands. That's sad reach. Hope you're good with your hands. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were sad reach. The clue was, hope you're good with your hands. It was, of course, charades. OK, time for our final letters game. John and Harriet, your turn to choose.
Do you want to choose? You yeah. know what you're doing. You
consonant,
choose.
Please.
Thank you, John. L.
L.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And a consonant, please.
W.
And a consonant, please.
D.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant, please.
S.
And a consonant, please.
G.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, P.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. Right, Joe, how many?
I've got a risky 8.
I would say a very fucking risky 8. It's just got a risky, OK. Sean, what have you got?
I've only got 5, Jimmy.
A 5, OK. Harriet?
Maybe I've got a 7.
Yeah, maybe you haven't. OK, John, what have you got?
A 5.
A 5, OK. What have you got, Sean?
Gulps.
John, what have you got?
Well, I thought I could get a better word, but plugs is all I had.
Sorry, what was that?
I thought I had a better word, but plugs is all I had.
Harriet, what was yours?
Sawdust.
She's got sawdust.
Oh, not even sawdust. Sawdust.
Sawdust.
Sawdust.
Sawdust.
Sawdust. Plugs.
Sawdust. Joe, what is your risky 8?
Dogs.
It might not be 8. It might
if there's a lot
eight.
Of them.
Yeah.
Lap dogs.
Maybe there's more than one.
Lap dogs, Joe. Lap dogs, you meant.
Lap dogs.
I mean, that's still 7, but... I'll tell you what, because it's Joe, we'll give you 7 points.
Yeah. What do you mean, because it's me? Oh, I love it, I love it, yeah.
Okay, could they have done any better?
7 was the best.
OK, so Sean and Joe have 36, John and Harriet have 40, so it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. It's all to play for. You ready?
Yeah.
Fingers on buzzers.
Oh,
your time starts now.
Where is it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Joe, have you seen a ghost?
Oh, no. I thought I had it. I genuinely thought I had it.
What did you think you had?
I thought it was dragonfly.
That's the right answer.
What?
Congratulations, Sean and Joe. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Recorder.
Oh, it's brilliant to see you.
Thanks to all our wonderful panelists, our studio audience, to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Next Friday from 9 o'clock, watching Us. Brand new friends and family and irregulars to Gogglebox is back on Channel 4. Adult Swim Fridays is next to Von E4, the genius inventor and not-so-genius grandson, Rick and Morty, brand new. Live Last Leg next tonight, Rosamund Pike, Tom Allen, nice mix.